All right, guys, we're just cleaning up. Welcome back. It's hard to like preface what just happened. So that's Dennis back there. You guys have seen Albert. You haven't seen Dennis because we haven't caught fish on his boat, but we've been on his boat probably 4 times total. Once we caught some halibut and we didn't make an episode out of that. Twice we did tuna out of Morro Bay and we skunked, so that didn't become a video, but today was the day. So we got a really good one for you today. So grab some popcorn, find yourself a comfy seat, sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Dennis has on this rod, he's got 200 pound mono, right?
Yeah, 200 pound mono on 100 pound braid.
100 pound braid, okay, yeah. Perfect. And another frequently asked question is, how fast do you let out and how far do you let out? And mainly what you wanna do is keep them far enough apart. So 15 seconds apart is a good rule of thumb. Send one out 100 yards and then count another 15 seconds on the other rod going out. And then that way you can make those tighter turns.
Gotcha. Both times we got bit, it was further distance.
Nice.
Yeah.
About how roughly, what do you think? How far?
Furthest distance is probably about 175 yards out.
We're gonna let these bad boys out and see if we can't get some later season tuna. Currently the end of October. And hopefully we can find them. But actually it's kind of the middle. These tuna, based on last year, we're here until the end of November. So we'll see. It's about a month more of this, potentially. So let's get some tuna on the deck.
So we're trying to find warmer water. And we've only been in like 53 degrees. And that's not ideal. For sure, so we're just trying to find that zone where it starts to really climb up. Last week there was like 63 degree water that Dennis says that he was fishing, and then we had biters last year at 58 degrees, so anywhere in that zone, 58 to 63, and then where there's that transition too, that's what we're looking for right now, and we've been having a heck of a time trying to find that this morning.
It's early. We'll find them.
I like that optimism.
Yeah, that's good optimism.
I like
that. Yeah, we're listening to the guys on the radio. Everyone's having trouble finding that warm water, and we're probably covering 20 miles with all the boats that are out here or more, and nobody's able to find anything over that 57 degrees. 56 is pretty common right now, and we just passed 55. So that's a big part of the game, is just water temp, water temp, water temp, water temp. We looked at tempbreak.com and it seems that they're very, very inaccurate right now. You never know until you come out. You can see what everything predicts, but real time on the water, that's what's gonna tell you. But we got one line out so far. We're running just one so that we can be nimble, but still try to find that temp break. And then we'll run two once we're in the zone.
All right,
we found a solid 57 degrees. Like 12 miles out, but we found it. We found it.
Dennis just says we found 58 degree water. Yep, there it is.
There she is.
And it's smooth.
Starting to see a little bit more activity as far as birds flying around right now.
A little bit more bird activity, yep. And it is 9:51. Hopefully that wind stays down for us, but it's definitely fishable.
After that last update, we stayed in that zone and we saw a lot of other boats in the area, so they were doing the same exact thing. But finally, we got our first sight of bluefin.
There they are, brother. There they are, brother.
There's tuna right there. Tuna right there.
Off in the distance at our 10 o'clock, we saw the full broadside of a nice sized tuna. Those fish we saw did not bite right away. We actually heard on the radio another boat in our zone caught a bluefin. But hours passed and all those boats disappeared. But we decided to just stay put because it's the right water, and we ended up seeing more and more life in that zone, and we saw some whales, and we ended up really concentrating in that area. And guys, it pays off.
Oh,
not gonna do it correctly, but I'm gonna grab the strap.
Turn them right, Ted.
All right.
I'm out of your way. Take a nice and slow. Right out of the slow.
Okay. We saw those whales.
Exactly. Hallelujah. Need help? You got it.
Yeah. Hold on there.
That's what a fish feels like.
Ah, oh, hallelujah.
Now. All right, you want to go ahead, work them on the reel, or yeah, you want to get them off?
Well, get the clip off.
Okay. I'm gonna get the belt.
Yeah, I'm gonna need it.
Huh?
Yeah.
Well, look at this. 1:45 in the afternoon.
Yep.
Nice. I like that little coral trout.
Yep.
There you go. Work them, work them. Not too fast, not too fast.
Okay.
You got them right there. You got them. Easy, Devin. Starts to want to run on you, let them take some light.
Okay.
We're looking good.
100 pound braid. We got 200 pound mono to a 200 millimeter Madmac in the nuclear trout color.
Yes, sir.
Just passed some whales.
There you go, buddy. You got him.
Nice. Nice.
All right. All right.
Yeah, it feels good.
Good. Come in, boss. So, don't trust this. This is yours. I'm gonna grab this. It'll be the first gap right there, and that'll be the secondary one.
Yep.
Because this is, it's easy. I need a new one.
No worries. I'll let you gap him, try to gap him in the head there.
Yeah.
Don't stop whining on
him. He's pulling.
Good.
Okay. You got enough drag letter to pull if he wants.
Not a boy, Ed.
I'm working on the boat, so you keep it to one side of the boat or the other, whichever side you tell me.
Okay. Oh, he's not happy.
He's in gear. It's in gear, so.
Right there, Ed. Come on.
I'm in the corner.
You're gonna walk up this way, Ed, when he gets closer to the front of the boat, so that way I can get back
yeah,
to the
ship
with
you,
brother.
Yep. I'll do my best.
Oh, you got him. Bring him home.
I'm excited.
Oh, yeah.
I'm so excited.
I didn't
see any deep color yet, Ed. Keep working on him.
What's he feel like, Ed?
He feels really good.
Alright.
Biggest fish I've probably got the pleasure of winding on so far in my life.
That last statement was incorrect. I did forget about this moment where I caught a 150 pound striped marlin.
There's those tail beats.
There they are.
Getting here a little bit forward. Give a little bump forward.
I want to turn it to the side.
Yeah.
Don't let him go on your boat. I'm going to turn it to the side, Ed.
Okay.
On this side.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep, he's upset.
He's pissed. Hold on. Is there enough drag?
Yeah, there's enough drag. There's enough drag.
No reason to muscle Ned.
See that little line out there? You're close to over there.
Don't let him stop. He's gonna get ahead of you.
Oh!
Woo! Hallelujah! Look at that bull bin.
Got him.
Oh sh! The belt came loose.
So we're gonna take the belt off. You're gonna take the belt off.
Yeah, the fighting belt came off because I had one too many burritos. Who am I kidding? I've been round and well fed for quite a while. That fish exerted so much force that I got a little extra wide and pop, came off.
Right here, bud.
Back.
It's okay.
Okay, you got it?
Yeah.
Now you might want to get him in that rock holder. He's a big boy.
And over here on this one. This one over here.
Turn the boat.
Cranking.
Keep the color, buddy. I see the color.
Get ready for the gaff.
I got the gaff. Let him run.
There you go.
Good job, brother.
We said it was going to be easy bringing him in, Ed. Come on, buddy.
Yeah.
Give you one little quick burst of run. I see deep color.
Albert's keeping the line away from the motor.
Yeah, deep color. I can see it now. Keep working it, Ed. Back to the model here. Oh shit, brother. Turn the boat.
He's
going underneath the boat. There you go.
Oh,
he's up
to
the surface.
Okay.
But I knew once we got the leader, I had to just like pull it out of the rod holder and lift on it, because Dennis was ready with that gaff, and had I just left in the rod holder and it let it go down, it might have come right back up near the propeller.
Gaff over here.
Nope.
Woo!
No, hit him up.
Yep. Let's go, Rick. 1, 2, 3, up.
He is.
Woo! Oh.
Nice. Where's the spike, brother?
What a battle.
Let me go grab the spike. Ed.
Yeah.
Look how keen he is. He's pretty.
Yeah.
Great job.
Oh, what a battle. That was fun.
That was epic. This is what we're out here all day for.
Yeah.
Bluefin tuna.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
We did our own thing,
we did
too.
This treble hook really sunk in.
Yeah.
Look at that.
BKK treble.
That's it.
All right, let's get him back out. I'll take care of the fish while we run.
Let's roll.
Oh, that's not even really a big one, but.
Yeah, great size.
That was a fun fight.
Right between your legs.
Right, yeah, I'm gonna go take care of this fish. So, I'm flushing it out. Just flushing out that cavity right now.
Sweet.
All right, so I made an incision.
Oh, look at that.
Right by the chest here, right towards the heart. And I don't know if you guys can see this, but if we get close, you can see where that water is oozing out of that lateral line, and it's just flushing out all that blood because of all the pressure that's built up inside that chest cavity.
Beautiful.
Take good care of them.
One aspect I really love about this kind of fishing is the amount of teamwork it takes to put these big fish on deck. We had to work together very effectively. Dennis kept driving the boat while I cleaned the fish, while Albert kept on letting line out so that we're reset and we did not waste any time. From start to finish, it took about 15 minutes to process the fish, take a few pictures, put it on ice, and get it out of the way and ready to catch another fish.
Keep at it. Don't get discouraged. Just keep going, keep going. It'll happen. And it, like it did.
Yeah. That was like hour number 6 or 7 for sure.
Yep.
And we've covered how many miles?
Trip intel today is 85 miles. We've done 85 miles today. Lots of trolling, lots of same zigzagging, but we stayed with our plan and we stuck to our plan and we were blessed.
Yeah. We did it, Albert!
We did it!
Dennis was ready with that wonderful gaff job. Albert was there for the follow-up and the great coaching.
Oh yeah.
And he was just eating his burrito. Now he gets to finish it.
Now can I finish my burrito?
But you handled it perfectly. You did it. Instinct took over.
I've seen it done once or twice.
You've been there.
A couple times. That was, you know what? That's funny to say, but that was my very first one to like reel in myself. I've always kind of been a little nervous. I like gaffing too. Gaffing is a whole lot of fun for me. It's another challenge in itself, but it's just such a big fish that it's always the unknown. It was like my first time getting a thresher shark. I was so scared, but then I got a thresher shark and then I was like, wait, that wasn't so bad. So that was not bad for the first bluefin. So, well, second bluefin. My first one was only 37 pounds. I take that big. I brought in another 30 pounder. So this is definitely the biggest one I brought in. So I'm still sweating. Adrenaline's starting to tone down a little bit, but that's what to expect. If you guys haven't done it yet and you're like kind of hyping yourself up to catch your first, those are the feelings that you go through right there. Hopefully you have a good team around you like these guys. Oh, and by the way, this is my third time going for tuna with Dennis. Third time's the charm.
That's right.
Woo. What's that?
They got the line and go over. Good side. Here, let me help Albert out. I'm gonna put it in neutral. Yeah. Keep going. Hang on. This might be the pig. Nope. Yep. No, you got plenty of drag there.
Woo! What were you just saying? Well, it's getting nautical, so we're gonna do one more pass.
I love that one more pass.
One more pass, and we're on, baby. We're on. Central Coast bluefin. So I'm reeling line up. Albert's still fighting that fish, putting constant pressure on it. Always keeping a bend in that rod, never let it go slack.
Oh, he's pissed.
He's mad. Another fish, baby.
They like my reel today.
Yeah.
You know?
Whoo!
Here we are, brother.
Bit again. There's one in the kill bag already.
One in the kill bag.
Dennis was just saying that it's getting a little choppy out here and we need to think about just making one more troll and then trolling back. And then once we're out of the temperature zone, we're gonna call it. But this fish had other plans.
Albert, how you doing over there, bud?
Baby, working on
nothing like a bent pole.
Oh yeah, working on them.
Good job.
Oh, let me get your fighting belt.
Okay, he's coming.
Yep.
Oh, you know what? I can probably put the rod on the other side.
Yep, that's good.
And I'll tighten it. Thank you. Nice swap, nice swap. That was a thing of beauty. Need to sign it?
Yeah, I'll do it for now. I'm gonna fight him right here.
So Albert's letting the rod holder do the work. This isn't his first rodeo. He works smart, not hard. You know what's funny? Dennis was saying, he was also saying, we were like, oh, how are we gonna fillet this? And we'll divide up that fish, one fish into three portions. Hey, what if we each come home with a fish? That might happen. Shout out to Robert Garcia. Said that the bite window is 2:30 to 4:30 and it's currently 2:50. Shout out to John too for a little bit of advice this morning. John Montgomery and Ramon. Ramon too. Thank you, Ramon. Good call, brother. Watching that temp break. So what's happening is Dennis is keeping us turned so that fish stays on the left side of the boat where Albert's fighting it. So he's continuing to adjust the motor. Albert's bit.
He's bit.
Gaining on him, gaining on him. Oh, you want this? All right, here.
Hell yeah, you can't. You can't take my all right, bug,
I got secondary gap.
No.
This is apparently this is Dennis's favorite part.
This is one of my favorite parts.
All right, technique. Don't let the fish rest.
Nope.
How are you doing, Albert? Good. Coming this way.
Right.
Do we need to bump it up a little bit more again?
No.
We're okay.
This one's, I think, a little heavier. This might be our toad.
Forward, turn the boat.
Yeah.
Deep color.
Oh yeah, deep color. Oh, that's a big one. That's a big one.
Got that gap right there, Ed?
Yeah. That's a big one.
We got a lot of weight on this side. Oh, she's a toad. She's a toad. Hang on, let her go. She's gonna run. I'm not gonna even touch it. I can't reach that far.
You're good.
I need to get her head.
I got her.
Oh my gosh, that's a big fish.
Right here?
Yeah.
Right there?
Yep. Yep. Oh my gosh. Thank you, Lord.
Woo!
This is a heavy one. So I need somebody that's gonna need to stand on that side of the boat.
Okay.
Got too much weight
and
on
then
the
grab
side.
Grab the reel, Albert, and then move back with it.
Hold on, get the reel off.
Thank you.
That's a nice fish.
Oh, this is one of the biggest ones I've seen.
Okay, hold on, let me get out of the way.
Okay. You ready?
Yep. One, two, three.
it's not a big deal. Oh my gosh.
Woo!
Oh my goodness. Yes. Amen. Hallelujah.
Oh my gosh.
Yes. Yes. Then go ahead.
Woo!
We got it, guys.
Nice.
We got it. Great fish. Thank you, Lord. You got it, bud. You're shaking. That's the way it should be.
That's a tank.
That's over 100 pounds.
That is a tank, boys and girls. That's a tank. Dennis, stand right here.
Teamwork, teamwork, baby.
Albert, stand right there,
yes,
too.
Yes, sir.
Come on, brother, be careful. She's gonna pop out. Oh my gosh, this thing's huge. Look how pretty that is.
Yep, yep.
Look how thick that is. Come on, brother.
Albert's freaking adrenaline is going nuts. Yeah. Oh my gosh. That is beautiful. Beautiful.
That's gotta be 100 plus.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. That is sweet.
Woo!
The Madmacs gets it again. Hallelujah.
Nice fight, Albert. Nice fight.
Nice fight. That was excellent.
Yeah.
Gosh, look at how big she is.
So right here. So, right there.
Uh-huh. Just up and down like that.
Nice. Where's the other? This flipper over a little bit, Ed. Okay. So I could get that hook out of that.
This one's the one that did the job right here. It's got the BKK treble hook. I believe it's a 5-aught. Interesting, it turned black in the water, but definitely got some rash from some tuna today.
The amount of time to take a hook to get a bite, it just takes some time. Sometimes we just have to be patient and wait. You know, you gotta wait and recheck the lines. Sometimes the lines get fouled up, they get some kelp on them, and or they cross and they get tangled up. So there's times that we gotta recheck the lines all over again.
Yeah, that's the stuff that they don't see.
Exactly.
You know?
Yeah.
You don't see the hours of waiting for a bite. We went for 6 hours without a bite.
Yeah, yeah, pretty much. But the thing is that we were able to have a zone that we picked out that was ideal, optimal. The water temperature was ideal. There was life out there. There was whales. We circled back around the whales a few times. How many passes did we take on the whales? At least 3 or 4 passes, right?
Look at this green.
Oh, that green? Oh, yeah, there you go. That proves on how many times we were circling around that golden zone right there where we were at.
That's how many.
There it is, right there.
We circled around that thing.
Yep. There it is, right there. Ed, get a close up on that. See that? And that's the captain's work right there. You got to have a good captain on the boat.
Aw, shucks.
Yes, sir. You got to have Captain Dennis. I mean, I'm tipping my hat off to you because that definitely, you put in the work and the time to make sure that we were staying in that zone, especially with the water temperature and the amount of life that we saw, the activity, the amount of boats that we saw passing us going in the opposite direction that kind of gave us that feeling like, should we stick it out? Should we keep to our game plan or should we head off to another direction? And nope, I think we all had the same gut feeling. Let's just stick to the game plan. The water temperature, everything looks good where we're at, right?
Yep, we had a great network of friends to assist us in this also. I mean, without great advice and wisdom from our companion fishermen, you just couldn't do this. This is a whole group thing, so thank you to everybody.
Albert's playing super humble. He was doing work, putting in lines, making sure they were at the right distance, just running back and forth. Albert's fishy, man. Albert's fishy.
Albert was back on that deck all day, watching the lines, watching for birds, checking the gear, reeling the gear, and always making sure that we were fishing, because if you're not fishing, you're not going to catch anything. So, great job, Albert, Ed, what a day. Yeah. Thank you.
Cheers, guys.
Great job, man. Great job.